Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss about artificial intelligence in detail. Now let us first understand the basic meaning of AI or artificial intelligence. See, according to the father of AI, who is John McCarthy, it is the science and engineering of making intelligent machines, okay, especially intelligent computer machines, computing machines, okay. So when a person or a human being is having intelligence, it is called natural intelligence, human intelligence. But when a machine is having any kind of intelligence, it is simply called artificial intelligence. Okay, we all know about Sophia Robo, who is having an intelligence of her own. That is, we have all the faded programming in the mind in the robo, but the point is that it is having its own intelligence, artificial intelligence. Okay, in simple terms, it is making you machines as intelligent as human beings. Okay, it is trying to make machines intelligent as human beings. Now, what are the components of AI? See, what are the things which are there in a human being? A sense. Okay, the person can see, hear, touch, feel, has emotions. So we are also trying to inculcate these emotions in the AI. Okay, so sense. Yes, the ability to see, listen, and also feel. So when we talk about Alexa or Echo, what is the feature? There is voice assistance, basically. It can basically hear us. There is a sense of hearing. It is related to the sense part, that is also very important. Alexa and Echo are the perfect example of this. Then comprehend. Yes, the comprehend is basically the ability to think. Okay, we all know about Sophia robot. It can think, it can answer us after giving a thinking. Okay, thought for it. Obviously, it is basically searching out from its coding or programming, that is all the information which is stored in it, but then we can call it thinking also. Okay, now act. Yes, acting is very important. Activity is basically a task, completing a task. Like we all know about Champa and Chameli, which are used in one of the famous restaurants of Odisha. Okay, they are the robots who deliver food to the customers sitting in the restaurant. Now, what are the objectives of AI? To help humans in certain tasks like assistance, analysis, surveillance, etc. Right? Yes, assistance. Which kind of assistance? Assistance, let's say, of doing a certain task. Okay, of giving certain service. Yes, Alexa is giving service of listening to us and then giving a certain or specific result. Okay, then also to reduce the stress and anxiety faced in doing repetitive work. Yes, repetitive work. There are so many works which are repetitive in nature, like clerical jobs. Okay, like machine parts fixing job in automobile industry. Okay, so now these works are basically mostly done by the AI. So repetitive jobs are basically create stress, and they are basically handled by AI very well, because here no extra thinking is required. Everything has to be done in a similar manner. Now, to increase the effectiveness and efficiency in certain tasks. Yes, efficiency and effectiveness has to be achieved. The result has to be completed on time. Everything has to be done without wasted of resources. So AI can be used in this. Now let us talk about the evolution of AI. See, in 1956, John McCarthy, as we all know, who is the father of AI, coined the term. In 1958, he developed a program which was known as LISP or List Processing Program for AI, for supporting AI activities. In 1964, Danny Bovro created an AI program student to solve the algebraic problems. Okay. In 1969, Shaky Robot was invented, the first robot. एंड अ रोबोट विद आईज वॉज इन्वेंटेड इन 1973 एंड ऑल्सो इन 1997 अ डीप ब्लू ए आई बेसिकली बीट द वर्ल्ड चैम्पियन गैरी कैस्परोव इन चेस चैम्पियनशिप. नाउ व्हाट आर द रिस्क्स इन ए आई रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ ह्यूमन जॉब्स एब्सोल्युटली स्पेशली रेपिटेटिव जॉब्स वेर इन देर इज नो थिंकिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड. दीज काइंड ऑफ जॉब्स आर हैव गॉन और बेसिकली आर इन द डेंजर ऑफ गोइंग स्पेशली क्लैरिकल जॉब्स. सो दिस इज द ग्रेटेस्ट बिगेस्ट रिस्क ऑफ ए आई दैट इट विल बी रिप्लेसिंग ह्यूमन बींग्स ह्यूमन्स विद द ए आई जॉब्स. ओके सो द थिंग इज टू बी सीन दैट हाउ फार इट कैन गिव द पर्सनलाइज एक्सपीरियंस टू ह्यूमन बींग्स. इट विल डिपेंड ऑन दिस दैट हाउ मेनी जॉब्स विल eventually be removed or eliminated. If the AI falls in wrong hands, it can be misused. Very right. If it falls in the hand of terrorists, if a surveillance system, AI based surveillance system falls in the hand of terrorists, what will happen? Terrorists will misuse it. For example, if India is surveilling a country, okay, its neighbor country, who is the terrorist? A terrorism promoting country, and if the surveillance system falls in the hand of a terrorist group of that country, what will happen? They will start surveilling our country only. Okay, risk of dependency on AI. Yes, when one is too much dependent on AI, then what will happen? We will be basically becoming very, very lazy. Okay, and this will lead to deterioration of our own self abilities, our mind. Our thinking abilities, okay, this will obviously lead to the deterioration in them. Now, what did we understand today? We understood the basic meaning of artificial intelligence. It's very simple that you are trying to give human intelligence to the machines, okay. And we talked about the components of AI, which is nothing but abilities that are associated with human beings also, giving those abilities to AI that humans have, like sense, listening, seeing, touching, feeling emotions and all, thinking and all. So a sense, first one, Alexa and Echo can listen. Then Siri of Apple can also, it's a strong AI basically, because it can basically fix everything according to what you have said, whether you talk about fixing a certain date for a meeting or putting an alarm or anything can be set according to you. It reminds you of everything when you have said it. Okay, then comprehend also. Yes, the AI can think in a way that it takes out all the information and comprehend on that information and then tells the answer. Okay, not the thinking that humans do basically. Okay, it's basically used with wisdom also. Then act, the performance or act of completing a task. Yes, certain tasks are fulfilled. Okay, then objectives of AI. Yes, to help humans in certain tasks like assistance, analysis, surveillance, etc. And to reduce the stress and anxiety faced in doing repetitive tasks. Repetitive tasks basically cause a kind of stress in the mind of the person because it is being done in the same way. So AI can also do it easily because there is no thinking that is required. To increase the effectiveness and efficiency, yes. And evolution of AI, when we talk about 1956, John McCarthy coined the term. 1958, he developed a list processing program, and in further 1964, Danny Bavrow made an AI program called Students to solve the algebraic problems. Then Shaky Robot was invented in 1963, and further robots with eyes was invented in 1973, and AI also beat Garry Kasparov, the world champion in chess. And we further talked about risks which are there in AI, like replacement of humans with AI, especially in case of work where there is no personalized experience given. It is a repetitive task. And when AI will fall in the wrong hands, it can become a disaster. In some cases, risk of dependency on AI, when's too much dependent on AI, asking to open the light through AI, TV through AI, and so what will happen? The person will not even do his basic work. Then this will lead to many problems. Now let us practice some questions. When was first robot invented? 1970 1973 1970 2000? None of the all. See, we discussed that 1973 first shaky robot was developed. Okay, so the correct answer would be B. Siri AI of Apple is which type of AI? Strong, weak, narrow, all of the all. See, we discussed it's a strong AI because it is something that listens to us. Okay, listens to us and fixes the time accordingly, whether to fix a date of meeting, time of meeting, alarm time, every time is fixed. Whatever we have planned, it is all fixed through Siri. You have to just tell it, say to it, and then it will fix it and remind us on proper time. Right, so this was all for today. Thank you so much for your time.